Good afternoon, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Investigators from the State Police Major Crimes Unit and a SWAT team converged on a home in Lancaster this morning where police are investigating a homicide. Police were called to Wesson Road early this morning where they found at least one person dead. Ray Brewer has more on what we know.
Throughout the morning, friends and family members of the deceased made the trek down Wesson Road to console each other. While officials haven't released any information, according to the friends and family members, the man was shot and the shooting happened around 3 in the morning. They also say he had 3 children. So far, the only official comment to come from the AG's office is that they are investigating a homicide that happened early in the morning. Officials aren't saying what happened, but throughout the morning, a steady stream of police vehicles could be seen heading up and down the road, including the State Police armored vehicle as the SWAT team was deployed. Shortly before 9, the State Police Major Crimes Unit van arrived. As investigators continued to gather evidence at the home, even more equipment was brought in. Around 9:15, the State Police Explosives Disposal Unit showing up in Lancaster.
Still very much an active scene there at Wesson Road. We should note that SWAT team members and an armored truck left the scene around 11 a.m. Stay with this website for the latest. Well, police have identified the 3 men who died in a single car crash late last night in Bristol. Police say their car went off the side of Route 3A, rolled through the air, and then hit a utility pole. 51-year-old Robert Urbanowski from Exeter was killed, as was the driver, 49-year-old Mark Walters from Bethel, Maine. Another passenger from Rhode Island was also killed. The cause of that crash is still under investigation. Police say speed was definitely a factor, and none of the men were wearing seatbelts. Lawyers for the man accused of shooting Manchester police officer Dan Daugherty on the city's west side last month want to make sure all the evidence in the case is protected. The defense from Miles Webster this morning asked a judge to preserve everything in the case, including 911 recordings, handwritten notes, forensic evidence, and medical records for Officer Daugherty. The judge has taken that request under advisement. Well, an interim president has been chosen to lead Dartmouth College following the election of President Jim Yong Kim to lead the World Bank. The Dartmouth Board of Trustees has approved, or appointed, I should say, Provost Carol Folt. Provost Folt's appointment will be effective July 1st. Folt became provost in 2009 and has been part of Dartmouth's first institution-wide faculty-led academic planning process. In a statement, she says she's honored to lead Dartmouth through this transition. Starting tonight at 5, troubling news at some of the nation's hospitals, a shortage of anesthesia, and in some cases, the consequences are fatal. Plus, as prices rise at the pump, the president takes on policing oil markets for price manipulation, the new action that was taken today. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.